You should definitely also, therapists can help validate your parents or make them feel better because a therapist is licensed a medical professional. And one way you can also talk to a therapist without having to be, tell your parents explicitly, oh, I'm trans, I want to see a therapist, to say, you know, mom, I've been talking to a friend who is seeing a psychologist about, you know, anxiety and schoolwork and anything like that. And ask if you could find one that maybe has your insurance that you could talk to. And don't frame it as a trans thing, because I think a lot of unaccepting parents would maybe try to find like a non-trans therapist or like a conversion therapist. So you want to be kind of broad about it. If you live in a conservative area, you could maybe try to find a therapist that takes your insurance and then say that your friend went to the person and that you think that it might help you do better in school or something random like that. I don't really know. Most parents don't get that trans kids go through different names. Yeah, that is very true. If I'm being realistic with all of you, I know that when you first come out and picking a name is like the most exciting thing and you want to call yourself fucking Caden or Levi or like Alex or Oliver or Calvin with a K, maybe ask your parents what they would have named you if you were a boy. I think down the line, especially if you are very binary and you kind of just want to transition and live your life as the gender that you identify with and be stealth, you don't want to pick a name that is stereotypically a trans guy name. And I know that a lot of people don't think about that, but that's something that I wish I had thought about, is picking a name, maybe even just Calvin with a C, because I don't know anybody else named Calvin with a K. I wish I had just picked a more generic white guy name, you know? And my parents did pick Calvin. I will say that they liked the name, and I gave them a list of, like, I wanted to keep the initial K, and I let them pick the name. But that did help my parents just pick the name. They picked something they liked, and that can help your parents as well. But yeah, a lot of trans people do go through different names, and just tell your parents that if you're gonna transition, you want to be 100% sure about everything in your transition, and that can make them understand that you're being more methodical about it, and you're really going through the process and picking something that feels right to you. You say, I want to be 100% correct with myself in this process. I'm taking it slow. I'm not just gonna pick one name that I kind of like, you know. I want to pick something that flows within our family, something like that, you know. Include them in it, like make them feel included, and that will make them more likely to go along with it. Also, I would definitely say that you should do research on trans stuff. I can try to like link some like studies down below, but really I used to have like a whole document of them, but I can ask my therapist for some to look, put in the links down below in this video. But it's pretty easy to do your own research on gender dysphoria, and you know how many trans people out there don't regret transition. There's a higher percentage of trans people who have medically transitioned that don't regret it than who do. I hate to say all this because I think there are some parents that just won't come around. I'm sure it can be hard for people out there watching this who like don't have supportive parents and never will, to like hear me talk about my supportive parents and like, oh, here's ways you could maybe try and your parents just don't get any of it. If you're in that situation, just remember that when you turn 18, you know, you gotta do what's best for you. I know that it can be really, really damaging to have your parents telling you that you're not valid, or having your other family members telling you that you're gonna detransition, especially if you fit the mold for the most perfect, you know, you felt this way since you were little, and then your parents are just like, don't understand at all, you know. Try to talk to friends, try to talk to even friends' parents. I knew this one kid who his parents were super unsupportive, but his best friend's parents were super supportive, and they were able to always make him feel welcome and validated and just feel better at their house, and that can go a long way for even just one person. So if you're a family member of someone who maybe has unsupportive parents, let's say your cousin has an unsupportive family, be the cousin to reach out and say, you know, I support you. I had these unsupportive aunt and uncle, right? And I remember when I first came out, they like made a point to like misgender me and like give me a card with my birth name on it. And my other family members who they knew I was trans, but they didn't really talk to me about it. Like, they made a point to come up to me and say, you know, we support you. Don't let them get to you. Like, we're always here for you. We support you. And that can go a long way. So even if you have to wait to medically transition, there are people in your life who will support you and who will help you feel validated, at least socially, for the time being. How to explain binding to your parents without them getting worried about you hurting yourself? I don't know about that one, to be honest. Maybe I would just tell them, I would send them GC2B's website. I think GC2B might have a portion of their website that talks about the safety of their binders, but tell them that, you know, as long as you wear one that is your appropriate size. If you've seen me like standing up or something, and your body's similar to mine, I was a medium, you can definitely tell your parents that you could even try a size up first and, you know, see how that feels. Or really, at the end of the day, I think I like saved up a bunch of money on like Visa gift cards in order to buy myself my first binder. But over time, I told my mom, and I like broke down one day because there was a swim binder that Underworks had. Don't buy it, by the way, it sucks. But I was super, super, super dysphoric, and my family was going on a trip to Florida. I think I told my mom, it was right before I had really talked to my dad. He knew immediately, but we didn't really talk about it. But my dad always called me the right pronouns and name always. He just didn't really talk to me about it at first. But my mom, I just like broke down to her about it and explained to her that I was gonna be so dysphoric if I didn't like somehow bind safely in the water, and that this was the safest option and that it was made for it. And she bought it for me, and it was like $50, and you know, that's a solid amount of money. And so sometimes the best thing you can do is just make them feel empathy for you. Like if you break down, like your parents are gonna know this is something that you are very upset about, and just say, you know, I don't normally do this, mom, but this is something that makes me very, very, very uncomfortable, and this is something that will help me so much. So yeah, sometimes you can just fucking be a crybaby about it. That's what I did. Why do we need to call you he? You've never been a daughter to us, just our kid. That's really hard. My parents said shit like that at first, where they're like, well, you know, you've always been our kid, and it almost sounds like, at least from just that your parents are trying in a way to make you feel more valid. But just tell them, like, you know, I just would really prefer for you to call me he. I would really prefer for you to call me by this name. I'm not gonna be mad at you if you slip up at first. Even if you can get your parents to not call you by your birth name and not call you by like gender specific terms, like, oh, this is my child, this is my kid, like, or just address you by a first letter. You know, for me, like, my birth name before was Kaylee, and I shortened it to Kale when I first came out because I knew that that would be easier for my parents to transition into. And my parents definitely, even though they had a harder time with calling me he at first, they just wouldn't use gender specific terms. They would just really avoid it because they didn't want to make me upset. What's about to come? Oh, so when it comes to medical transition, so if parents want to know like the general timeline of medically transitioning, now this can vary from state to state where you go, things like that. When I transitioned, I came out at, when I just turned 15, I came out as trans. I first told my family and those who were very close to me, and I transitioned like over the summer between school years. So when I came back to school in the fall, I emailed my counselor and had them send like a mass email to my teacher saying, you know, this student is transgender, he would prefer to go by this name, he would prefer to go by these pronouns, and all my teachers were very supportive about it. The first thing I think that any parent should do is set up a psychologist, therapy, counselor appointment with somebody who is knowledgeable on gender topics, but also is a general psychologist who knows a broad group of psychology topics. And then when that therapist is talking about hormones and stuff, they can talk to you, they can talk to your parents, and depending where you live, you may need a letter to start on hormones. But you generally have a thing called informed consent in a lot of places where you just need your parents to sign off and you to sign off. You don't necessarily need a therapist, though I would 1000% recommend it. You make an appointment at like an endocrinologist, or usually an endocrinologist, a trans-friendly endocrinologist. Planned Parenthood does it as well. And they will talk to you about the changes of T, and they will teach you how to do the shot. I would recommend to do subcutaneous shots. They're so much better than intramuscular shots. And the shots are like super easy. The needle for sub-Q is like this big. It just like goes in like the fat on your stomach. And then surgery is a little more complicated. You do probably need psychologist letters for most places. And a lot of times insurance has like hoops to jump through. But I had surgery when I was 17, and I recovered very well from top surgery. I was ready like to walk around, like just like do normal things by the second day. It's just kind of drains that are a nuisance. Recovery can be really easy from top surgery, and those are the two major things that I think a lot of younger trans people go through, is top surgery and T. And they're both fairly simple procedures to go through. I mean, top surgery is considered like, oh, surgery, but it's really not that big of a deal, and the healing time for top surgery is very worth it compared to how much better you'll feel. I really do think it's medically necessary for people with FTM gender dysphoria. Isn't a packer and dildo the same thing? I hate that word, like the second one, because a packer isn't that. You know, a lot of times a packer isn't even necessarily for sex. A soft packer can be something that really helps your dysphoria. I know it can be very, very awkward to ask your parents for that type of thing. I never asked my parents to buy me a packer ever, like, full disclosure. I could not have done that. My parents know about them. Like, I talked about them to my parents like over time, when like they were like, oh, why do you have that? And I'm like, oh, well, it's because, you know, it's for my dysphoria. I didn't want to talk about sex at the time. You know, pack and plays are different too, because when you have like a dildo or strap on for like a girl on girl type of thing, you're only using it for sexual purpose. There's no other purpose than sexual. But like with a trans guy, pack and play, or like even like just a fake penis that can be for sexual use, they're very, very realistic. They try to make them as realistic as possible, the ones that are meant for FTMs, because it's very, very validating. It helps alleviate dysphoria in a very dysphoria inducing situation like sex, because trans people want to live normal lives. We want to have sex with people, you know, without feeling dysphoria. For a lot of people, it's just going to make your life much more normal. It's going to make sex a much more positive experience for you. Also, a lot of the times your insurance will cover hormones. Egg retrieval, that is a whole thing that I did not go through. I would recommend reaching out to either No Offense or my cousin Arden. I'll put both of their Instagrams like right here. They are both two people I know who went through the process. For me, I just didn't see the point in it, because knowing that my egg could be used for a child and that would therefore make me biologically, I'm a very like biologically fueled person. If your egg was like the egg the baby came from, you're the mother of the child biologically. It doesn't matter if you live a father role. Like, I would live my whole life as a child's father, never even talking about it. But I would know in my mind that I'm like the mother of the child. And I don't like that shit. That would make me dysphoric, that would make me probably resent my kid, so not for me. But definitely talk to your parents about that if you're interested in it. Is it worth transitioning if you risk your child becoming a target for bullying and violence? That is a really difficult question. A lot of the time, it's really hard for a parent to feel like their child is gonna be bullied or something or have prejudice, but at the end of the day, it's still important for your child to live their most authentic life, and it's gonna be easier for your kid to deal with bullying. If your kid is transitioned, you know, and living very happily, bullies, I never really got bullied ever, for full disclosure. I was never really bullied in high school. After I transitioned really, like 11th and 12th grade, and became a much more likable person, I was pretty popular at school, to be honest, and I never had any issues with dating friends or bullying or anything like that. Now I live in a very accepting place. I went to a very accepting high school, but I think that it's important to monitor how your kid feels, to monitor the people at school, to encourage your child to speak up if they're being bullied. Encourage your child that it's not a bad thing to go and talk to the counselor or talk to a teacher, because 99% of the time they're gonna wanna help, and they don't want bullying in the school, you know? They wanna have a clean record, especially if your school strives for diversity. They do not want their trans students getting picked on. That is a big thing. This is the last question I'm gonna answer, and I'm sorry that I didn't answer more, but someone asked, my parents think gender and sexuality are the same thing. That is something, any parent watching this right now, gender and sexuality are very different, as I said. A very masculine girl who likes to date girls is very different than a masculine trans guy who also likes to date girls, even if they're both born female. The difference between a lesbian, a girl who just likes to date girls, is that they just like, that's just sexuality, that's just sex, you know? That doesn't have to do with your own physical body, the way that you feel when you're alone in your house looking in the mirror. Gender is how you perceive yourself, how others perceive you, how you walk through society, whereas sexuality really only pertains to people you're dating or having sex with, you know? Those things, they don't really go hand in hand. It's very ignorant to believe that gender expression, sex, all these things are the same thing, because anybody who in the past 20 years, 10 years maybe, has gone through farther than general psychology, general sociology, would understand that there are a difference between these things, and that trans people are having a way different living experience than a gay person. If I could have just lived my life as a lesbian, I would have done it. When I was a lesbian before I transitioned, I was a girl that liked girls. I was just as unhappy as I was when I identified as straight. You know, I was dating girls and I was having sex with girls, but I was just as unhappy with myself. Nothing changed in terms of before I decided to come out as gay and date girls and stuff. I still had this very internal struggle with my body and with the way that people were. It just felt so wrong to be called she and her, and it felt that way my whole life, you know? A lot of trans people will feel gender dysphoria and feel the implications of misgendering, even if it's not misgendering at the time. They'll feel the dysphoria from that before they even develop sexual feelings. I was telling my mom that I was a boy and that I wanted to be called Kyle and I wanted to have a penis before I was old enough to even want to date anyone or have sex with anyone. So you just have to keep that in mind, and that you can do your own research. Parents, I always recommend doing research. Make sure you're looking at sources that are unbiased. You don't want to go into it with a closed mind, because you're going to end up gravitating towards sites that have a right-leaning bias, and anybody who's doing research on anything should be fact-checking and looking into the bias of any source that you're looking at. You know, it's okay to look to something that leans a little one way or the other, but you don't want to be on an alt-right website looking at trans people. You're just going to get a completely skewered view of it, and you also don't want to be on an alt-left trans website telling you that every single gender in the book is valid. You don't want to do all that. You want to go ahead and do research in an unbiased, scientific way that will really shed light on what trans people go through, can explain to you the medical and scientific reasoning and study behind transgender people and what we go through on a daily basis. So thank you guys for watching. I'm sorry I couldn't answer more questions, but I hope that this answered a lot of them. I will see you guys next time. I love your face.